In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, yeah!
An angel in disguise. But if you meet a friendly horse, will you communicate by
When the district was formed, we knew that we didn't have the capacity to currently serve all the K through 5 students in our district. And we knew this was going to be something that we needed.
Our superintendent, Jason Manuel, actually went around Germantown with a map to try to identify property that would work for an elementary school. From there, a task force made up of professionals, teachers, parents, city administration, all worked together to choose a site that we felt would be most viable.
From that committee work and from that process, we narrowed it down to 4 sites to choose from, and ultimately we chose the Brower-Schaefer property where we're currently building the school.
It has the ability to become a community school. It also offered us a unique setting and to be able to put an elementary school in a situation where we could bring this incredible piece of property and all it offered from a natural perspective into the building.
When we look at neighborhood schools, we want to make sure that the parents in the neighborhoods that were impacted played a role in this decision-making process.
We really need storage space. We really need this kind of activity space, how the flow of the building went.
It was really exciting to me to hear from particularly the teachers and the administrators in the room.
We feel like this is an opportunity for everyone to own this project.
It was a great collaborative effort from the professionals and the members of the design committee.
One of our concerns at the beginning of this project was it was a really tight timeline. We're talking about building a 106,000 plus square foot facility in 1 year. So it takes a village to get that building up.
But what was really good about it, even though we had a compressed schedule, the project team, GMSD, the contractors, Baldwin Shell, and HUH, all came together and were making decisions quickly to get the school open on time.
My hope is that they use all of the functionality that we've built into the building.
The teachers are going to get to walk in to all new furniture. They have the brand new active board for teaching. They've got whiteboards, desks, chairs. It's really set up to be a flexible seating classroom as well.
We also have shared spaces where I hope the teachers can do extended projects that don't necessarily require them to have everything cleaned up at the end of, you know, a certain hour.
They've really thought about everything that goes into making a classroom culture conducive to learning.
So one of the unique features about the gym floor is that it's a hardwood floor. The gym can be used for a number of different things. It can be used for community events. It can be used for youth basketball. It can be used for so many different things. I think one of my favorite things about Forest Hill Elementary School are the outdoor features to the campus. You've got this big beautiful tree and several trees that surround the campus. You've got the lake. You've also got the courtyard area that's really unique and special. There are all types of different unique and special things, but as the students are interacting with that play space and that outdoor space, they're also surrounded by just natural beauty.
I was so excited to see that the preschool rooms, first of all, were in the kindergarten hallways. Wonderful size of the rooms, the lighting, the windows to outside, the large restrooms in each of the preschool rooms, just really anything that you could think of were put in those rooms for the preschool population. One of the other things the design committee talked about was the STEM lab, and it's a beautiful space with moving tables, anything you can imagine. There's sinks in the room, you can do so many science activities, math activities, there's a wall of windows looking to the outside so you can do observations.
When we designed the areas of music and art, we really thought about those places being a space to do the things that they were designed to be for. And so working with music teachers to think about what they would build for their dream space was really important. Same with art. When we're teaching children about shadow in a visual arts class, how can we use the space around us to do that? When you go into our library, there's lots of spaces for students to get engaged with books. So we want it to be a comfortable space, flexible seating. All of the books are brand new. So we want everyone to feel like it was made just for them, for any day, to always be a part of.
We do have multiple meeting spaces available for either parent conferences, meetings, or for teachers to be able to conduct their work that goes on outside of the classroom.
The activity room, as it is now come to fruition, is actually a unique space that will be able to be utilized by all of our teachers. It will enable them the ability to come out of their classrooms, go to a unique setting, and do special projects.
One thing that we wanted to make sure was that there was going to be built-in storage. So we have two large cabinets for the teachers, as well as some built-in cubbies that are going to go above the backpack hooks, and that it makes it fun. It is appealing, it's colorful, it brings some color into the classroom, but the teachers are going to have everything that they need to store all of the materials that they use throughout the year.
There are a lot of things, I think, looking at our existing theatrical facilities here in GMSD, there's a wish list there. And starting from scratch, we've sort of checked everything off the list, from upgraded lighting and sound to a dedicated sound and technician booth in the back of the house, a ramp that goes behind the stage that is long and a good gradual slope, making it safe for wheelchairs, but also great for queuing up large numbers of children that are going to come on stage for big, giant and exciting theatrical numbers that I know they're going to have.
One of the main goals of the project was to deliver and provide as much natural daylight as possible in the project. We achieved that by several different means. One is we created special rooms that allows daylight to pass through them. We had vertical circulation. Stairwells also had a lot of glass in it, so it allowed daylight to come into the project. And we used the use of clear stories to wash feature walls within the project itself.
When we look forward in the future to what Forest Hill is going to mean to the city of Germantown, I want people to think, wow, that's an incredible space, for them to really feel that this was designed for them because it was designed by them.